हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल लर्न अबाउट द सर्कुलर मोशन। इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल लर्न अबाउट द बेसिक कंसेप्ट ऑफ सर्कुलर मोशन, दैट इज एंगुलर डिस्प्लेसमेंट, एंगुलर वेलोसिटी, एंगुलर एक्सेलरेशन एंड फॉलोड बाय सेंट्रीपेटल एक्सेलरेशन एंड सेंट्रीफ्यूगल एक्सेलरेशन। द प्री रिक्वेस्टीज ऑफ दिस लेक्चर इज At least you should know the basic mathematical concepts like addition, subtraction, division, multiplication. You should also know the basic fundamental physics laws and their equations. You have to go through the equations of linear motions, different equations under linear motions, Newton's equations under linear motions, and you also have to know about the dimensional analysis. What we learned in our earlier lectures. So, with this help, you can understand the circular. The objective of today's lecture is to understand the basic concept of uniform circular motion. And with this concepts of uniform circular motion, we can understand the angular displacement, angular velocity and angular acceleration under circular motion. Further, we can apply the concepts of uniform circular motion to understand the centripetal acceleration and centripetal force followed by centrifugal force. Let's discuss about the uniform circular motion. It's clear from its name that any motion, then circular motion with a constant speed is known as uniform circular motion. Since we know that velocity is the vector quantity, so it will have the direction as well as magnitude. So magnitude is not changing, only direction is changing. That's why we defined that uniform circular motion is a motion along a circular path in which there is no change in the speed, only change in the direction. So its magnitude is not changing, but direction is changing. That causes a uniform circular motion. In other way, we also can define that uniform circular motion. In a uniform circular motion, a body travels at a constant speed on a circular path. You can see that through this figure that if we fixed a ball through a thread and try to rotate, then we can say that this motion will be the circular motion. Why this motion will be the circular motion? It will contains the velocity that will be same at each point, but the direction of the velocity is changing at each point. Let's see more. See here the velocity. See here the velocity. See here the velocity. The value is same, but the direction is changing. So due to the force acting towards the center of this circle, that is known as the centripetal force. And in this way we can say that constant velocity tangent to the path and constant force towards the center will cause uniform circular motion. There are many examples of uniform circular motion in our daily life, that if ball at end of the string revolving, that will also be the circular motion. The movement of our planets around the sun is also example of uniform circular motion. The movement of moon around the earth is also a circular motion. So in this way we can understand that if anything is moving in a circle with uniform velocity and with changing the direction of the velocity, that motion will be known as the uniform circular motion. Now we learn about the definition of uniform circular motion. That was, whenever an object is moving with a constant speed through a circle, that will be known as the circular motion, but the direction of the velocity is changing. The question is that An outward force can be resolved by asking what happens when the string breaks. If the string breaks, what will happen? If that is the uniform circular motion, if the string will break, what will happen? If the string will break, the ball go through the tangential direction. The ball move in a tangent of the path, not outward as might be expected. Means the ball will not go in this way. Ball will move in a tangent way. Here, if the string will cut, this will go in this side. Here, string will break, then it will go in this side. Here, string will break, it will go in this side. Here, if string will break, it will go in this side. Not go in just outward. Because why? Because there is always a force acting on this object that try to move the object towards the center. That's why it's called a central force. Means if we remove the central force, will the ball continues goes in a straight line. So in this way, we can say that if any object is moving in a circular motion, there will be a central force that acts towards the center of that circle. So centripetal force is needed to change the direction of an object that moving in a uniform circular motion. How? While it can also be said that centripetal force is needed for a uniform circular motion. Let's define the basic some concepts of uniform circular motion. The first one is the radian. What is radian? If any object is moving in a uniform circular motion, here we can say the figure. If object is moving in any form circular motion, let's suppose the object is moves from here to point here. So what will be the radian? Radian will define, will measure the angle in angle. So the radian is the unit of angular measure. So it is defined as the arc length, that is here s, this distance divided by radius of the circle. So mathematically you can say that theta is equal to s upon r. That is defined as the radian. We know that the value of one radian is 57.3 degree. Let's define the angular displacement. What is the angular displacement? The axis of rotation is the center of any disk is fixed, then we have to need to fix the reference line. First we fix the reference line, and if you got the reference line, we can define the angular displacement. During time t, the reference line moves through an angle theta, so that will be the angular displacement. If we got the position from that reference line, means theta is the angle between this line, reference line, to point P. That will be the theta. That is known as the angular displacement. Mathematically, we can define the angular displacement is the angle of the object rotate through during some time interval. So that will be the theta is equal to theta final minus theta initial. The unit of angular displacement is again in radian. So each point on the object undergo the same angular displacement like we saw in the figure. Each point will undergo the same angular displacement. Now we will discuss about the average angular speed. What will be the average angular speed? We can see the figure. The average angular speed, that is denoted by omega, is of a rotating rigid object is the ratio of the angular displacement to the time interval. Let's suppose that initially object was there here. After time t, it will move to t, it is to tf. So initially there is the angular displacement theta 1, and after time tf that will reach to theta f. So the angular will average angular speed is denoted by theta by t. So theta will be theta final minus theta initial divided by the time taken. So also we can say that unit of angular speeds are radians upon a second. In short form, it is denoted by radian upon second. So it will be the positive and it will may be the negative. So speed will be the positive if theta is increasing, means the motion is will be in the counterclockwise, and speed will be negative if theta is decreasing, means the motion will be in the clockwise direction. So in this way we can estimate the average angular speed of any circular moving object. If we got to know the average angular speed, then we can also calculate the average angular acceleration. What is that? The average angular acceleration of an object is defined as the ratio of the change in the angular speed to the time it takes for the object to undergo the change. That is denoted by alpha is equal to final angular speed minus initial angular speed divided by time t. So the unit of angular acceleration will be radian upon second square. In short form, it is denoted by radian upon rad upon s square. It may be the positive angular acceleration or in the counterclockwise direction, as same like average angular speed, and the negative angular acceleration will be in the clockwise direction, same like average angular speed. So further, whenever a rigid body rotates about a fixed axis, every portion of the object has the same angular speed and the same average angular acceleration. For any object, if you got the average angular acceleration at any point, then you can find the you can say that whole object having the same average angular acceleration. So if we learn like radian, angular displacement, angular velocity, angular acceleration, then we can come that we can understand what are the analogies between linear and rotational motion. Here we denote the linear motion with the constant according to distance in x, velocity in v, and acceleration in a. But in rotational motion, we fix the axis and constant like angular displacement, that is theta, angular velocity, that is small omega, and angular acceleration is alpha. So let's compare the equations. We know the equation, so v is equal to v naught plus at in linear motion, but in rotational motion or circular motion, the equation will be omega equal to omega naught plus alpha t, where we put the velocity, linear velocity, here angular velocity, linear initial velocity, angular initial velocity, acceleration, linear acceleration, here is the angular acceleration, and t is the time, that is the same in both motion. V average equal to half v naught plus v. In similar way, here rotational motion speed average will be this half of that. X equal to x naught plus b naught t plus half at square. Here theta equal to theta naught plus omega naught t plus half alpha t square. Alpha here is a is equal to b square minus v naught square upon 2 x minus x naught. In similar way, alpha equal to omega square minus omega naught square divided by 2 theta minus theta naught. So if we know the analogies between the linear and circular motions, now come to know the relationship between the angular and linear quantities. Like displacement is equal to x equal to theta into r. Speed will be the v equal to omega into r. Acceleration will be a is equal to alpha into r. So every point on the rotating object had the same angular motion. Every point on the rotating object does not have the same linear motion. So in this way, we can got to know the relationship between the angular and linear quantities like x equal to theta r, v equal to omega r. That is the important question, important relation, that linear velocity is equal to circular velocity or angular velocity multiplied by r radius or distance. So in this way, if we use these things, we can solve many numerical equations related to circular and linear motions. If you are going to solve the some numericals, then you have to know about the circular motion, that length of the circumference is equal to 2 pi r, 2 pi and r is the radius of the circle, and you can estimate the time period t. The time period is known as the time in which the object complete the one revolution, one circle, that is equal to t. So t is equal to 2 pi r by b. So a is equal to, we know that b square by r, we put the value of v 2 pi r chi square upon r into t square. So in this way, we can find the a is equal to 4 pi square r by t square. Sometimes we write t is a tau, the time period for rotational motion, that is denoted by tau, but in linear motion that is denoted by t. So in this way, if we know these things, we can calculate, we can estimate the different numericals, given numericals for a circular motion related with linear motions. Now we can conclude what we learned today. We learned the basic concept of circular motion, in which we got to know the definition of uniform circular motion. What was the uniform circular motion? If an object is moving at a constant velocity but in a circle, but its direction is changing, that will be known as the uniform circular motion. That is important in our real life to solve, to understand the basic, many basic problems like the movement of planet around the sun, the movement of moon around the earth is under the uniform circular motion. In this lecture, we studied about the angular displacement, that is denoted by theta, angular velocity, that is denoted by omega, and angular acceleration, that is alpha. And we also learn the relationship between the linear and the circular motions, that in linear motion be denoted by s x b a. X is the displacement, b is the velocity, a is the acceleration, but in circular motion be defined as a theta is angular displacement, omega is the angular velocity, and alpha is a angular acceleration. So in this way, a student can apply the basic concept to understand the centripetal force and centripetal acceleration through this concept of uniform circular motion. Now come to the practice questions. You know the formula, you know the equations, whatever we studied today, then you can interpret the angular velocity for a rotation with 78 revolutions per minute. You can interpret the angular velocity for a fine turns at a rate 900 rpm. You can find the tangential speeds of 20 centimeter long blade. You can calculate the acceleration for uniformly accelerated 1200 rpm in 20 seconds. Further, the question is given that a wheel start from the rest and rotate with a constant angular acceleration and reaches an angular speed of 12 radian per second in 3 seconds then you can estimate the magnitude of angular acceleration of the wheel, the angle in which rotate in 3 seconds, and through which angle does the wheel rotate between time is equal to between this time to this time. So if you know the basic concept of today's lecture, you can solve these questions properly. Thank you for listening to the lecture. Thank you so much.